Hey, welcome back, everybody. Sign here again with another episode of Enigmatica 2 Expert Mode. And I've been up here in my little Britannia area doing some stuff. It's jankety, but I've automated living wood and living stone. So, living wood was easy. Right, got a block placer from Cyclic, well, two of them. And they were both placing the infused wood. Controlled miner, got it whitelisted to living wood. Not a problem. Breaks it, drops it in the world, vacuum chest picks it up. Now, the problem I ran into is that Living Rock actually has a mining level. And this thing was breaking it slowly as well, but it was actually destroying it, not dropping the block. So, a little experimentation, the auto breaker from Max Traditions, that can break Living Rock without destroying it. One thing is getting it to trigger when you want it to. So, I've got a block placed underneath there, and let's go ahead and cover this up now. And then here I have a sensor from RF Tools. It's looking for living rock, just one block by the sensor, only looking for one of them. And when it gets that, it triggers a redstone pulse, which fires off this auto breaker. And this pulse stays going until the breaker actually breaks the block, and it's been working pretty good. Got myself my terrestrial agglomeration plate. So, that thing works great. Made myself a Rosa Arcana, so I got something to use experience for now. This is making mana right now, anyway. Which, it does a pretty good job. Got the Into Flames. I got Ormorillus, which I've just been feeding it food I get from quests. Don't feed it the same food twice in a row. It doesn't appreciate that. It produces far less mana. Let's see. Oh, hey, look. Yeah, you did spawn. I was doing an experiment, because there's a quest to make a Narslimus, which prevents slimes from spawning in a slime chunk, and for every spawn it prevents, it produces mana. However, I get the slime cube, right? But this is a quest reward way back when. Well, slimes to spawn in the chunk it's in. Unlike vanilla chunks, slimes can spawn at any height and do so at a significantly increased rate. So, yeah, it's not quite working. I don't think this thing's generated any mana yet. So, that's a shame. Let's see. Yeah, including actually additions to jams. It's been working pretty good. Couldn't finish draining off my experience. Yep. And I have made a whole whopping single piece of Terra Steel because it takes a ton of mana to do so. About half a mana pool. Not great. But, meh. Whatever. I don't have any automatic ways to produce mana yet, so yeah, kind of a pain. I'm thinking I might go the Red Pole route that I did in Ultimate Alchemy Exam. Worked pretty good. It was kind of set it and forget it. And this guy is for anything doing the altar. Let's change that back just in case. But let's see. Other things I made. Rod of the Plentiful Mantle. Basically reveals ores for you. Rod of the Seas. Unlimited water. Jaded Amaranthus. Functional flower. A couple died for this. Basically, you feed it mana, and it makes mystical flowers grow. So, it works out pretty good. Hopper Hawk, basically just a vacuum hopper. Baconia, oh, it, you know, turns sand into clay. Brought a Shifting Crust, I got that as a quest reward a long time ago, which it was a quest as well, so. Yeah, is what it is. And let's see. Well, good way to check to see what I've done is look at the quest book. So I made the Mana Seer Monocle and Sparks. Sparks is so I can transfer mana from here to the agglomeration plate. Pretty easy. And they're cheap. So, let's see. Mana Seer Monocle. Put that, it's a bauble, right? You put it on, you look at a flower, you see the area effect of that flower. Turns out, friggin' Into Flames have a huge area that they affect. where was it at? Oh, it's still in my inventory. I also made Benevolent Goddess's Charm. Basically, creepers do a whole lot less damage, and whenever they do blow up, they don't damage the terrain. So, cost mana, but it works. Yes, that's the range of an End of Flame. 7x7? I thought it was like 5x5, so... I'm gonna beat you down with a stick, dude. And... don't think I need any of that, so... But hey, got a little bit of experience. Beat the flower. Yeah, this thing just sucks down experience and turns it straight into mana. Not bad. Well, hello. And I modified my, little, hilltop here. The 2 blocks high all the way around to keep things from sneaking up here on me. Just because I get tired of dealing, turn around, there's a creeper in my face. Yep. Monocle away. It's handy whenever I'm doing stuff, but not something I need to wear all the time. Let's see, yep, there's a Benevolent Goddess's Charm. Rod of the Seas, Plentiful Mantle, Equal Trade, which is the Shifting Crust. And then the Rod of Terra Firma. Our Sludgement's mana, it will raise or lower the ground around you. Oh, the level you're standing on. Oh, nice. Keep the Rod of Lands on you. The land cost placing dirt will be lessened. You can destroy most stone-type blocks. Consult the Lexicon of Titania for additional information. Cool. Hopperhawk, Jaded, Cliconia, Gormoros, give it food, produces mana. Narslimus. Let's see. Sojourner's Sash. Basically, ups your jump height, run speed, and gives you auto step up. Cool. It works. I like the speed boost. Makes running around a whole lot better. Terrestrial Agglomeration Plate. Make a little, small multi-block. You throw a mana pearl, mana diamond, and a mana steel on it. And yep, takes half a pull, mana pool worth of mana. Sparks, yep. Transfer mana around wirelessly. Terra Firma. Look at that. Shifting Crust, just it's block swapper. Let's see. And it's got its benefits. It's not limited to a two-dimensional space, so. That does make a bit of a difference. Yeah, Relicies, use mana, make water. Covered the Goddess Charm. Let's go ahead and open some of these, because... Oh, Pink Cherry Sapling. Just one. Dude. Go away. God, you're annoying. Chartle of Puta, power 10. Another floating island. 16 status upgrades. Cool. 16 lily pads. Cyan Banner. I'm 16. Good lord. Ammon, sweet pickle sandwich. You can have that. And we'll drop that off. Okay. Let's see. Speed upgrades from Nuclear Craft. And that was a quest. And you're annoying. You need to go away. Need that or that. I was going for the Elementium. Which is right there now. And Magical Boomerang. Ooh, that's a toy to play with. Alright, so the Chartle of Puta is going to go here for now. Banners can go away for now. And the arrows. Hi. Boom. Nano boots, yeah, whatever. Unfortunately, I'm not quite high enough that skeletons aren't a hassle. Alright, so that can go away as well. It probably does away. Let's go toss a spider at the Gormoralis. See what happens. Huh? It likes it. Alright, go. Doing good on food myself. We'll play with that later here. Speed upgrades, I'm just gonna keep on me. Terra Steel quest. I'm gonna need a lot of it. So I need to get a good mana generation system going. Monocle, pretty handy. Narslimiz. Gormoralis. And just simply two different types of foods. A little tricky to automate, but not terrible. And if you feed it before it's done eating, it will just keep mowing down, but you don't get any extra mana out of it. So. And then Clayconia. Alright. Sweet potato pie. Guess what? Have a snack. Reinforcement times 3. Oh, nice. Times 3 is good. Cactus times 16. Ham and sweet pickle. Oh, I should check that. Yeah, see, it still has mana in it, so it's not done digesting yet. And usually just for kicks, I wait till that's done. But yeah, the spider's done emptying itself. Beef Wellington. Cool. Inventory upgrade. Which I'm gonna stick away from because... Oh, did work. Wow. That's quite a bit. And light blue stained glass. Fizzled to look like bricks. Alright, cool. Yeah, I think that's pretty good for now. And yeah. Next is going to be Natura pylons, right? I like the old version better, but okay, so that's three. Basically, I just need one Terra Steel and I can make the Elven Gateway thing. So I need a couple Maniples as well. So, how's that again? Oh yeah, Rock Crystal, White Petal Block, Light Gray. Before I do that, I may want to hook up that Jaded Amaranthus. Clear that out. I should just be able to do this. Yep, that works. If there's not enough mana or room for mana, it's wasted. So, and then your turn. And for now, I'm just gonna toss stuff in here. And we're gonna worry about other things. Like the fact that I need rock crystals. And that a bunch of my particles have disappeared and I don't know what happened. Mana spiders. I have no idea if they're firing or not. The little lightning effects over here whenever your the runic altar's done. Nothing. There's a few others too, but I have a feeling that finding rock crystals is going to be even harder because, well, I can't see the little light things, so I'm not sure what happened, but yeah, they're gone. Oh, let's go to nuclear craft. Heat upgrade. Note that some machines will reset their work if they run out of power, like the pressurizer will. It's just like, yeah, nope. Not doing it. Include, like, the pressurizer. See the machine's tooltip. Yeah. Tacos. I have not eaten a taco yet. And ice pillars. Oh, hi. Away. Was there any other quests that I did purposely or accidentally? Extra utilities didn't have anything for the boomerang, did it? Nope. Okay. Oh yes, IC2, I made the fluid solid canning machine on camera, and never did the quest for it. And the block cutting machine, yeah, I did that a while ago, but... The next is the ore washing plant, which, not something that's a high priority for me. Iron mill. How many? 10. Cool. And 4 slime blocks. Minecraft slime blocks, though. So. Need to set up like a GP production area. Seems like it might be a good idea. They're just kind of got it scattered everywhere right now. Thaumcraft, I haven't done Jack and Thaumcraft actually for a while. You know, the Astral, did a lot of it all at once and that was it. Biogenerator, never claimed the quest from that last episode. Osmium. Refined obsidian. Glowstone. Osglascos. That just... Yeah, I have no idea. Don't think I'm saying it right, but oh well. Pineapple ham. New food. Cool. Basalt weather bricks. Chicken celery casserole. Signalum plated impulse item ducks. Transfers 4,000 arithmetic plus items. And 48 of them. Cool. And mechanism wind generator. Right, well. Some of this stuff away. 2 wind generators. Awesome. Alright, let's I can pick up items, right? Yep. And experience orbs. Cool. I'm liking it. Is there anything around here I can stun? Here's slime. Actually does decent damage too. Not the fastest, but I think it's still probably faster than a bow. And if you're right next to the guy, then yep, even faster. That lily of the valley, huh? I have my little pouch on me. Yep. And that's a tall one, so yeah, leave it alone. Yeah, my little botanicary is probably gonna have to expand out, I think. Kinda looking at it here. It's not doing terrible, but I don't think it's enough room. Especially, this needs to go. Right, this really does not need to be here. And, jaded amaranthus, I'm gonna have to set something up for that. But, let's see. Some of the stuff put away. Connectors to it. Connectors in here. I have some MVs. Okay. Grab some aluminum. And do I have any HV wire coils? No. I do have 2 HV capacitors. Oh, really? Oh, that's right, because I made 3 to make capacitors with, or made extras to make these things with. So, steel, which I finally started making again. But still, I'm going to need a lot more. Oh yes, and I kind of sort of automated ore, you know, duplication anyway. Let's see, 3 ores here. Pulverizer, auto inputs, grinds it up, shunts it into the redstone furnace, which shunts it into here. Now, certain things don't work, like I ran into some another lapis ore that jammed the system up for a bit. Cinnabar has to go straight to the furnace. Yada yada yada. Fourth, right? But yeah. And lag spike. Nice one too. What does it happen after 20 minutes of recording? And so let's see, Thaumcraft, huh? Okay, it was running auras in a different dimension and that overloaded the server. Okay, whatever. Thaumcraft is trying to read auras in a dimension that's not even loaded. Use that. That we're good to go there. We'll get our wind generators on the bar. I really should be making another power cube for these things, and holy balls are loud. Wacky around with this thing. Let's toss one there, I guess, and one there. Good work. And more power for me. Probably just go ahead and leave these in here. I need a good sized mountain around here though. That's kind of the problem I'm running into. There's no like real tall mountains around here for me to put that on. So I do have that other shard of Laputa now. In here? No. Up in Batania. I could just grab a chunk of land somewhere close by, elevate it like I did that, and then like put the wind generators and whatnot up there. That's an idea. Alright, let's put some this way. I don't want those. I'll do that off camera. We've already determined that I don't need to do that. The OBS is just too intensive to run Shard of Laputa and record at the same time. Also, where's my capacitor? Here we go. Almost right around. Damn you. Stupid getting stuck to the mouse thing. Right, so currently we're, yep, doing great. I haven't checked my tree farm for a bit, though. You've seen that double tall flower over there thinking it's a damn creeper. Oh, this is awesome. I like this. It brings the armor back because it strips it off of them. That way they can't keep re-equipping it. Holy crap. There it is. If you miss, man, it can be gone quite a while. Yeah, I think it went all the way over there. Can I hit him? No, leaf block in the way. Okay, how about here? Stop just before it got him. Okay. I can't break leaf blocks, huh? That's a shame. Alright, let's make sure everything's doing alright. Yep, you're definitely full. Alright, so that's still running good. I'm not even gonna bother keeping that. I did need. I don't think I need the chest plate though. I think I need the helmet still. For Tear Steel. Oh, I haven't looked in on this in a little bit here. Doing okay. And. Out. Yeah, I ate the pineapple pork chop or pineapple ham. By the way, let's put our some of the avocados in here. Come down here. Okay, so honey's still full. There's actually saplings in there for once. That's pretty much backfilled. Look at that. These both have ethanol in them, and you're at. Oh, you just ticked over 6 million out of 40. So plenty of power. Well, until I start running like a mass fab or something. Yeah. When it comes to that block, there's no such thing as enough power. Right, let's go check out our armor collection here. I need the helmet. Okay. Kind of curious though. We're gonna grab a stack of coal. I've been making steel. I'm running a stack of coal through here. And this is how fast it is. It's a signalum tier, so not even max tier yet. But this is without any augments. It's just that fast. Also, I just realized I have some mana steel boots up here I need to get rid of. Four. And then I grab a stack of iron. Being low on again. Let's grab like two. Yeah, it's gonna 6,000 RF tech right now. I don't know if that's actually worth it. I'm gonna put it all in there. Yeah, 45,000 RF tech. That's more than the conduit's gonna handle, so I think four is about the max we can do. Speed multiplier times 5, power multiplier times 15. Which that's actually not bad. If I put up to 5, 21,000, I think the conduits can handle, I can't tell. What is it? 25, so I could probably deal with that. 322 steel, though. That's pretty decent. I got a lot of iron in there, though, too. Let's see. That away. I can put celery casserole away. I'll just drop those off in there for now. Got to leave the cooking oil behind. What was I doing? Yeah. I'm gonna stack coal here. And let's go with augment. Coil, right? Auxiliary reception coil. hopefully have one left so I can. Okay, yeah, got a few left. And it, that was appreciable difference. And then at 5, is this going to be able to keep up? Looks like it. And it's flying through just about as fast as the redstone furnace was, so. Of course, the redstone furnace isn't taking that much power, but. $386 steel. Not too shabby. Grab, like, all our iron, so I quit thinking I'm out of it. 800. I am still pretty damn close to out of iron. 1024. Yeah, about halfway to where I feel comfortable. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Just making smooth stone in there. Probably can just go ahead and. Oh, come on. There we go. Cool. Alright, so. Mechanism quests. Basically, it's like the heat generator for the most part. I think. Advanced tier. So advanced tier requires just reinforced. I could probably do this, but I don't know. I'm not really feeling like it. There's not a. No. Well, part of bragging rights is unlocked, but nothing I can actually do. A little better than the normal builder's one. Yeah, just a hidden. Or a smidgen. See though. Yeah, I don't feel like using the dynamos either. That's. They'd really have to be ramped up to be worth it. Oh, yep, power cell quest. And another phosic resonator. Yay. All right. Controllers, screens. Oh, that's crafter tier 3 is why. I was thinking it was a builder. I don't think I've gotten a builder before. Oh, yes, the quarry card. This is a little bit of a fun one. So, 4 RF tools machine frames, a reinforced cell frame, which you have to fill with lumium, of all things, and yeah, it's hardened, plus these guys. Hardened is a regular frame, steel rod, Invar plate, Invar gear, steel casing. Yeah, energy cell frame is a machine frame plus a ton of redstone. And yeah, machine frames we've seen. Yeah, that's not great. Cymetal hammerhead. Enderium hammerhead. Manulin hammerhead. And this one. I'm not even going to try to pronounce it right now. Yeah. Yeah, that's not a friendly recipe, let's put it that way. Not a whole lot I can do with an RF tools right now, when you get down to it. Could make a magician blood orb, I guess. I mean, oh, let's try to do the advanced crafting, like crafting table, the base one. Let's at advanced. Basic. That'll work, it's right here. So, crafting table times 2. Easy one. Let's see, I need that 4, 8, 9 of these. I need this luminescence. Just grab a bunch of, because I'm doing all right on resources right now for that anyway. 8 of these. One of these. That should. Super AE derping there. That should be it. All right. And it's a crafting table. But I can make the creative builder's wand in here. Make the advanced one in here. And reactor controller, like, you know, well, legacy, but. Lead large plate. Fission controller, fission reactor casing. The controller is basic, actually. Can I make another nuclear furnace? Say one of these things. Yep. Now, this goes into that, so I'm going to need one of you. And any luck? Almost. Need the plates. What type are they? Advanced plating. So four of those equals a fission controller. Build a multi-block reactor using reactor casing, reactor cells, coolers, and moderator blocks. Place the controller along an edge at a corner or within one of the faces of the structure. Splitting the atom and quest complete. Fission controller. I don't think I'm actually going to. I might. Basic energy relay crystal times 4. That's good. I like it. I'm kind of on the fence though about doing this. So let's get our 8 lead. You're currently on? Yeah, it's fine. Oh, yes. I need 36. Actually, I need what? 8, 12 thin sled plates. It would be like 12 blocks of lead, which I don't have currently. Alright, okay. I have 12 blocks of lead. Oh, let's see, what else was there? Fission reactor casings. I should be able to do that, I think. I just need 4, right? So that's just like a recipe's worth. Alright, so you into that. I need more basic plating. Oh, yes. I remember that now. What goes in the middle again? Graphite block. Correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't I just cook up like 2 stacks of graphite here? One of which we're going to turn into steel here. I'll make 2 recipes worth, I guess. Alright, so uses for you includes that item. And I just put that stuff away. Go here, start doing this out, I guess. And that's just 2 uranium plates. I should have my large plate should be done by now. I still had ore hanging out down here. I had gotten most of it processed with this. Alright, so back over to here. 1, 2. Lead large plate. So you probably stalled out because you ran out of room. A little bit of tick acceleration ever. I've almost said never hurt anyone, but yeah, I've seen really bad things happen, so. I think it's safe to say it has hurt people before, so. Alright, so these guys. The basic machine casing. I might actually have that. Nope. Alright, damn it. Okay, do I have a bunch of tin in here? I do. Silver. Yeah, there's my tin. Okay, well, you're done now, so that's good. And we'll do that into here. And it's done. One. Oh, yeah. And two. I need three of these things, unfortunately. I need a generator and an advanced circuit. So one of these guys, advanced control circuit, will work. I think I put my old generator away. Now what else am I looking at here? That's it, right? Nuclear reactor. In you go. Reactor controller legacy. That away, put those away, wait for the quest book to catch up. That is a gate quest done. Item reward, 4 blocks of uranium, 16 reactor casing legacies, 16 reactor glass. There is no extreme reactors chapter, but nuclear craft and industrial craft granted access to the mod. Cyanite, plutonium, ludicrite, anglesite, and bonita white will all be needed for the endgame. Alright, well, let's put that stuff away. And was there anything else I can use this for? Right now. Nope, I can start working on this, like advanced catalyst. Is just this stuff plus gold, so I mean, I just need black iron for that. Ultimate is, yep, emerald. Elite's diamond, I'm guessing, yep. And basic siren. Okay. There's still no recipe for the unbreakable wand. Likely building scepter. Easily doable right now. Doable right now. Should I be able to scrape together enough XP for all that? Oh, and I wonder. Do I have another? I still have that nether star I got, right? So let's try this. Sit. Hey, look at that. All right, can I? Okay, I need to dip into my dank null here. Where all my bone blocks are. It was on the ground. I don't actually need those in my system. There's not much point in doing that. One and two. We're gonna grab a couple diamonds here. And head over to the factory. Run through our enrichment chamber. You got hard carbon on your chest plate. Hey. That is a way to actually strip everything off of a guy, isn't it? That didn't sound quite right. But yeah, that should work. Let's go here. Cut down to the Botania area. I'm gonna stand here for a second and generate a little mana, drink of water because my throat just all of a sudden got super dry. And I am here for probably eight will do. Eight will be perfect. So then it's you. Like so, right? Two diamond wands. Now I just need, eight magical wood. So, bookshelf times eight. Oops, I made an extra. Okay, while I'm here, boron's trash. Hard carbon is good. Tough alloy boots is good. You know, I can run those through the arc furnace too. Forgot about this crafting station up here. Alright, and I can't remember what it was up there for. That's where I was put my ME controller together. Alright. Four. Boom. A little tedious, but I think I have a wisp outside. Yep. That's the most efficient use of my XP. And I keep clicking on that damn storage bus. I should be able to craft these in this though, because this recipe actually doesn't take experience. One, two, three, four. Create a builder's wand. And it didn't use the cyclic building scepters up. Okay, that's interesting. Alright. Okay, good. It's not super cheesy. I had to check. I really did. I was like, nah, it can't be a thing. Can it? Alright, so bragging rights, though. Create a builder's wand. That's it, huh? Well, it is a bragging rights quest, but let's see. Creative mill. What are you looking at? Not something that easy, is it? Let's see. The Everlasting Guilty Pool. Yeah. Fabulous Mana Pools, huh? Shimmer Rock. which is Living Rock plus Bifrost. Okay. Book creative base, randomly filled with books. All right, so Big Writing Books by Douglas Adams. Okay. True Gun Printing Press and that. Okay. And it's just, it's not magic books or enchanted books. It's books. Mana Tablet Creative. Ah, there we go. I'm like, yeah, that's not the right recipe. Echimeris. So looking at Creative Mill. Okay. I need 12 amazing Opinium cores. Which... Alright, so they start off as 4 red coal around block iron. Not terrible. IC2 creative generator. 2 human header buckets. Okay. Create a fluid tank. Mechanism. Thing. Yeah, I need to. I'm gonna make all these creative items, I think. Neutronium ingots, yeah. I mean, after a certain point. But I'm thinking about trying to make them without this. Oops. 4 chaotic cores, the Twilight Force Master Trophy, yeah. Anglesite. Flux Sponge. Oh, there's no recipe for that one? Oh, that sucks. And this is probably the easiest of the recipes to make, but it's only a creative modifier for your tool. Creative Wireless Crafting. Creative Power Cell, really? 1-to-1, that's it. I gotta make like 2 of these. Tier 4, Tier 5, Dilithium, Benitoite. Californium, RTG. Which this is gonna be some fun stuff to get my hands on. Let's see. Here we go, that's what it was. Heb 248, 249. Yeah, okay. Now, how do I make this? Like, that is 249, 252. Okay, so I have to get the stuff the hard way anyway. Hello, fusion reactors. All right, let's put that away then, I guess. And I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode. I hope you're enjoying the series. Until next time, Science signing out. Have fun.